one of the problems of making this 1875 to 1885 Buckby banjo playable again is that it has a raised ivory-type carving in the middle of the neck. This creates all kinds of problems because you need to have a flat neck to get a clear sound when you're playing and pressing the strings down on the fretboard. So I needed to come up with a way to make it flat. This is where I traced, using paper, the neck, so I could cut out some thin veneers of darker wood to place on the top of the neck. Here you can see the top of the neck I've already done to level it off. Now I need to start my work on the bottom of the neck, and that was what I was working on most of yesterday. Here I'm fastening the bottom piece on with some clamps, and there I flipped it over and working on some other. You can kind of see that I'm flattening it out to have a better shot of it later. Here's a shot of what it looked like before. Again, you can see the brownness and how it sticks up above the fretboard. Here's afterwards, after I put the veneers on the outside. Here's a better shot of how it lifts up off the board. And here it is after I flattened it down again, so that the veneers leveled everything off. You can see across the neck, it's nice and flat now. Nothing sticks up. So then the next thing, I wanted to put some fret markers in, and so I worked on that all day today using a Dremel tool and some other colors of wood. I went ahead and put in fret markers. There it is, all finished up. And here's a shot of the neck. Video of it. I think the 5th, the 7th, 9th and the 12th, I think, fret markers are a little bit fatter than the rest of them, so that I can identify those. This banjo only had 12 frets on it, which is one of the reasons, one of the things that made me think it was a very old Buckby.